One problem with digging out a large area this far down below ground is you're gonna uncover some slime chunks. You want to see something kind of weird? Look at this. I've got sea lanterns in the floor here. And of course, if I put a block on top of it here, it creates a dark spot all around, right? Because it's not covering up the light. And in fact, if I go and look, my light level's here, 9, 10. Okay. What was that? If I do that, but if I put a shulker box on there, look. Doesn't change the light level at all. Shulker boxes are transparent. I had no idea. The wiki says that they're transparent. I just never had a really good reason to go look at the transparency values of shulker boxes. I pulled this down for a reason. I wanted some more sea lanterns. Boop. Yeah, so that was kind of cool. Which means you could make kind of like using carpet in the floor. You wouldn't necessarily want to use shulker boxes in that, but shulker boxes have kind of a weird texture on the bottom, right? So if we go and make, if I go put a couple blocks here, right, and take out this, and I put the shulker box here, and then take out this. Look, they got this swirly pattern there, and you could put light behind it. It would be recessed, so it would be reduced by one block, but that's kind of cool. You could do crazy swirly patterns on your walls in different colors because you can dye the shulker boxes and have nice recessed lighting. Yeah, that's kind of cool. What's going on here? Should be kind of obvious. I had this beacon was over here and I dug out this area, right? I moved it over 100 blocks and I'm digging out this area. Yeah, no real good reason. I have picked up some decent resources from it. Not that I need this stuff, but yeah, you know, over a stack of diamond ore. Not as much lapis as I would have thought, which is kind of surprising. Anyway, whoops, don't do that. Okay. Boop. Ooh, spooky noise. Yeah, so the reason I was doing this, I've had a kind of a weird week and haven't had a lot of time to build, you know, actual projects of any sort. So I've just been coming down here mining. And so, because the mine part of Minecraft, I find rather relaxing. So, oops, get rid of that. So yeah, I like just coming down and digging away. And where you run into lava pools, that's no fun. It takes a little bit of work to work around, but you know, it's doable. So I'm just clearing out. I'm being clumsy is what's going on. Just clearing out areas. So I'm digging tunnels through here where the lights in the floor will be or would be. And then I can just walk through and without having to worry about laying torches, go and just take care of the rest of it. I find it relaxing and relatively, I mean, you have to pay attention. Oops. Especially when you run into caves and lava and stuff like that, you do have to pay attention. But it's relaxing and it's something you can do while you're trying to wind down for the day or watching TV. Yeah. Oops. Yeah, so hi. This is Theron. Welcome to Minecraft LAN Party. I think I didn't do that. How are you? How's your time been? Doing all right. I had The MS Walk was last weekend, and it went well. It went really well. I am up to $2,165, I think, on the fundraiser. Put a link to it in the description. It's still available. The fundraising year goes until September, I think. So I can still raise money for the 2018 fundraising year. And there's still MS walks going on. There's at least one I know of going on this weekend, this coming weekend, which is cool. So the money's all for a good cause, and it all kind of goes to the same place. So, there we go. Now I'm to the back hallway here, and this goes all the way into the corner, and then I dug this one out to the main part there. So got 1, 2, 3, 4 more of these little tunnels to dig, and then I can walk down, check on the health of my pick here, and then I can just walk through and speed mine all this beautiful stone. Oops. Have to be a little careful because A, there could be gravel up there, and I hear skeletons, and I've heard zombies over here. Not sure where they are, so I could be digging up into caves, where they are, and then they can jump down and try to kill me. That's not good. So, one more there. Yeah. So anyway, my pockets are not full. Why did I not pick all this stuff up? I don't know. Anyway. So, MS Walk is done. I walked 5 kilometers. It's approximately 3.2 miles for our non-metric speaking friends. And, ow! You weren't very, very nice. Even though I was trying to kill you. So this, digging out this area here, as you can see, there is some lava in here, and I've still got some lava below the floor there, and, whoa, shoot, see what I mean? Okay, put this back on the bar, let's go kill a witch. You can't just rely on arrows to do because she's got healing potions. Ah, there we go. Eat. Whew. See, it's dangerous around here. I've got a ravine here that I dug up into. And where'd that witch come from? I see glimmering lights up there. Oh, there's an Enderman up there. Be careful. So I intend to build a wall here. Let's see if I can. And there's a pool of lava, so I want to tear down this wall, and I want to make this all nice and neat and clean. So I want to take gravel. I've got more gravel in the boxes over there. Just put on some gravel here to fill up some of this, and then make it easy to get rid of this wall of obsidian. And I think there's more lava up here. So it's a pain in the butt. And then this is going to be an interesting challenge. Stuff's always easier. Lava's always easier to deal with when you're above it. Oh, there is definitely a cave or something right here. Oh, goodness. Oh, anyway. So this is fun. I enjoy this kind of stuff. I've found some caves here. I lit them up. Oh. Let me show you something. Is it up here? I think it's up here. Hopefully this is safer. No witch is going to drop on my head. Yeah, it's over there. Look at this. The world's smallest abandoned mineshaft. Hello, Mr. Zombie. Are you going to call all your friends? Yeah, here they come. Oh, I need to be a little careful here. Oh, they're coming in. Wow. Whoa. There we go. Hey, one of them dropped some iron. Oh. I thought I saw one up here. Let's get some torches down up here. Ooh, mushrooms. Oh, that. there's beasties up there. Haven't done much caving. Anyway, I thought this was really cute. Clearly, mineshaft and then ravine generated through it. And I think there's more of it up there. I can see the wood. So I haven't gone up there yet. I'm going to build a bridge across here and go up. I want to secure some of this area here first, though, because no good reason for going over there only to let all the mobs in behind you. So, anyway. And then once I do all that, ha, 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 ha. Oh boy. So that kind of proves that the zombie summoning thing, they don't need a low light level to spawn their buddies. Because this is all non-spawnable down here, unless someone spawned up there and jumped down. Don't know. Anyway, so what was I talking about? I've got all kinds of stuff here. Let me dump some things off. I hear another witch. Oh boy, so, what were we talking about? MS Walk. Done with that topic. I've had kind of a weird, we're back at the back walkway again, and no witches here. Goodness. So, yeah, I haven't had, the walk was last weekend, it kind of, wow, I have to figure out where the cave is here. I'm probably digging right up into it. We will find out if there's a bunch of mobs in the walkway by me when I get done. No mobs. yeah, so I didn't do a whole lot last week, and I didn't record anything. The last two videos I released were both recorded at the same time, or on the same day. Week before MS Walk. But, so this, the walk was last weekend. I'm recording this on a Sunday. And I've been working all weekend, so I haven't gotten much done. I was actually planning on working on some stuff earlier in the week. Ooh, that's so creepy, hearing that witch laughing at you. But, oops. Okay, so it's not there. Can I get that? No. There we go. Ooh, okay. So now I've carved out the corner here. Pardon me. Yeah, so... yeah, this weekend. So I was... on Friday afternoon. Late Friday afternoon. Of course, all the horrible things really happened at like 4 p.m. on Friday. I got... dumped in my lap that we had some work that was due on Tuesday, and it was kind of a last minute sort of deal, and it's stuff that I am literally the only person who can do, which is kind of annoying, which means I had to work on it. And in order to I mean, it was one of these situations where I probably could have just said, oh, we're not going to be able to get it done. I won't be able to work on it until Monday. But it's probably better if we tell the customer that we'll make our best effort and then actually pull it off. And then if I took care of it this weekend, then I don't have to worry about it during the week because I have other work to do, and some of the same resources would have been used for the work. So it was one of these things that no one told me I had to work. Oops. Nobody told me I had to come in this weekend, but honestly, it was kind of a self-defense sort of move because it'll make my week a lot better to have kind of a miserable weekend. So that's it's kind of a lame, but it's the way it goes sometimes. And I didn't have too much on my plate this weekend, fortunately. And we had Crash Space annual meeting, which I am the head, I'm the chairman of the board, and I'm chair of the board of directors, which means it's my job to conduct the meeting, or, you know, to kick off the meeting and sort of make sure it all happens. So it's one of the few things as chair that I'm obliged to do. So so we had that this evening. I went into work this morning before it. I went to the meeting in the evening, and then I went back to work to check on the things that I set up in the morning. So it's been one of those weekends. So oops. Oh, hello, Mr. Redstone. Let me get you to. There we go. And so I'm probably going to be, it's a little bit late right now on Sunday. I'm not going to get to bed nearly as early as I normally would. So, mainly because I wanted to get this recorded and possibly edited tonight so I can post it on Monday when I usually do. And so I let them know that, yeah, you know, I worked all weekend. I'm going to be a little late on Monday. And I've got a few things that I really should have done this weekend and didn't because I was at work for most of it. So I'm going to try and get some of that done tomorrow morning. And then Thursday, whoops. Oh, I'll take this redstone. Thursday, I might not even go into the office. We'll see. I've got plans to go to the Magic Castle on Thursday night, which is kind of exciting. So we'll bring some friends and I was asked if I could get tickets to the castle. The Magic Castle is a member, it's like a private club for magicians. In the right place? 1, 2, 3, 4, yes. But one of the perks of being a member, which I am not, at least not yet, one of the perks of being a member is that you can bring guests, and members get a certain number of guest passes each month or each year, I'm not sure which they can hand out. And the guest passes are great, and anybody can go, and the member doesn't need to be there. The great thing about them is, or the reason that they do that, why it's so great that you can get guest passes, is they are a private club, but they make a lot of, I mean, they make a lot of their money from dues, because the members pay a fair amount of money each year to be members. But in addition to that, they do allow guests to come. And when the guests come, they are obligated to eat dinner at their restaurant. It's a nice restaurant, but it's, you know, it's a little on the pricey side. And of course, all those people tend to drink. And there are bars every 10 feet inside the Magic Castle. So there are plenty of opportunities to get drinks. So they make a fair amount of revenue from guests who show up and come and eat dinner and come to see the shows, which is great. I chose this Thursday because there's a magician named Pitt Hartling, who I own one of his books. Never seen him perform. And I'm curious to see if he performs any of the tricks from the book. We will see. So that's kind of exciting. He's a German magician. So we will see. So that's on the plan. That's on the docket for the rest of the week. So I'm out of sea lanterns. Let me go get more. So that's pretty much the rest of the week. Just take it away here. And I have sea lanterns. You can go here. I can drop off some of the stuff. Sea lanterns. I may take some of these diamonds and make a new pick out of it. I have three sort of efficiency 5 silk touch picks. But when digging out a big area like this, it's useful to have more. So I may go make some more. So anyway, I think that's about it. It's sort of, I don't have much else to say because I haven't been doing a whole lot. Need to dig out this area, see where those caves are. And, oh, you know what? Let me show you something else. One other thing. Llama, llama, llama. For some reason, there are two llamas in the Nether. I like the guy with the bandit glasses. And there's a new... hallway up here. With the new portal. Goes to the future site of the amusement park. Let's go take a look. Okay, look at this. So this is a big flat area. It wasn't always flat. Oh, look at that. So this is the road from out of town, which is over here. Oh, there we go. This goes back to the community area. Skeleton horses. There's a village over there. So yeah, we put up this. Well, this is really Barb Makes Things and Eric Hulk have been doing all this work. Look at that. I wonder what that is. And these little towers, which are pretty cool. And there's the horse stable. So it's going to be amusement park. Going to be like roller coaster. Hello. Roller coaster and, I don't know, other stuff. We'll see. And this is all slabbed. Just a little cuckoo. See it from the air. So there's a desert temple off on the outskirts. So this whole desert area with oh, that's an amphitheater. Nice. I need me some bunnies, so I will probably come and get some from here. Because I saw a rabbit right there. Multiple rabbits. There's a bunch of them. And now that we have a portal, I can maybe get them back over to the witch farm. But I need a place to put them first, so maybe I'll work on that next. Because I want a rabbit farm. So that I can brew leaping potions. Not that I use leaping potions a whole lot, but Oh, it's a little trough for the horse. So you can put your horse on, tie up your horse here, and they have water to drink. That's amazing. Okay, I know Barb Mix thinks is around here somewhere. Just don't know where. But anyway, this is Flattenberry. Oh, let's go look at the amphitheater, because that's kind of cool. And there's a fly machine mechanism. What's going on up here? Oh, water. Fountain. Water fountain. Nice. We get some banners for a backdrop. Seating. Little stage. Ah, super cool. Anyway, I have to figure out what to build around here. I think it might be a boat race track. Lay out some packed ice track and then race around in boats so you can race your friends. I think that'll be cool. Anyway, that's it for now, for sure, this time. And thank you for watching. This is Theron. It's been Minecraft LAN Party, and I will see you next time.